As some of you may know, I was lucky enough to have lived in Buenos Aires, Argentina, for about 18 months with my dad and my brother. We've been back for about 2 years now, but I still remember the amazing time I had there. Throughout our stay, we went to Iguazu Falls and hiked next to monkeys and coati on a waterfall almost twice as big as Niagara Falls. We went to Lima, Peru, Salta, Patagonia, and many other places. In those places, we did things like hike with llamas and donkeys up the side of a mountain in Salta. We went to an ice bar after climbing on a glacier in Patagonia, and we skied the slopes of the Andes next to a cliff with our close friends. As you may guess, these things were all very expensive, and we were really lucky to be able to go. Throughout all of this time, my dad was a member of an organization called SACS, Send a Child to School. And what they did was this. They partnered with the poorer schools in Argentina and gave all of the kids new backpacks and school supplies that they would need for the upcoming year. They would travel to these schools a lot and always needed volunteers. So Henry and I would always go and help our dad with whatever they needed us to do. Sometimes it was organizing backpacks. Others, we had to carry huge bags of paper and pencils to other volunteers that would then sort them and give them to the next volunteers to put into the backpacks and hand them on. But we would always help. The kids that went to these schools were always so proud to be even going to school. They always had to sit through some lecture or speech, but they wouldn't mind it because they knew that they were going to get new things afterwards. And that was all they could think about. They were always happy and grateful. They took us on a tour of their school. It was about the size of ours, but with 3 times the amount of students. The floors were an uncomfortable cement that had cracks in it everywhere. They sold homemade hand sanitizer for money, and their English teacher couldn't have a conversation with us in English. It makes you grateful for what you have at your school. It's very important to give back to the community, whether it's yours or someone else's. If they are in need, you should help if you're able to. That is why I mentioned the fact that I did all of those luxurious things that not many other people are able to do. Because back then, I wasn't as thankful or as grateful as I'd like to think I am now. In my experience in this world, in my many 14 years alive, many people aren't grateful for what they have and always want something else. My suggestion to you is this. Look at what you have and what you don't, and be grateful that you have what you have.